Now, one more thing. You note that the shuffle routine, both the one that we wrote and the random.shuffle from the standard Python library, return none. That is, they don't return a useful value, they just return nothing. And the idea of the shuffle routine is that they modify the input. So there's this eternal tension in programming between computing a result and doing something. So functions like square root and sine function and so on take an input and return a result. They don't modify the input, they create a new value as a result. But functions or subroutines or methods like shuffle are different. They take an input and modify that input. They take the state of the world and do something to the state of the world rather than just compute a result. We talk of these functions that compute a result as pure functions, and these that do something as impure, and I like to talk of them as subroutines rather than functions, because they aren't functions in the mathematical sense. They have an effect on the world. Now, you'll see that most of the code that I show in this class is of the computing type rather than the doing type. And the main reason for this is that the computing code is easier to test. So if I wanted to write a test for a computing function, for a pure function, I can do something like assert sorted of the list 3, 2, 1 equals 1, 2, 3. A single line, and I'm done. On the other hand, if I want to test a subroutine that does something that affects the state of the world, I have to first set up some state. So let's say input equals 3, 2, 1. Then I have to call the subroutine or method, say input dot sort. And then I have to inspect the state to see what happened. So I would assert that input is now equal to, oops, let's make sure we have double equal signs there. Input is now equal to 1, 2, 3. So in this case, there's not that much difference. So we have a library method sort and a built-in function sorted. And with the built-in function, it's a single line to test. With the doing subroutine, it's three lines to test. But in general, as we add more state and we have functions that do rather than compute, it's going to be more work to set up the state, invoke the method, and then test it. And it's easier to do the test for pure functions. And that's why I prefer them when they make sense and stick to the doing approach only when necessary. When there's a lot of state that we have to deal with, then we go ahead and write methods or subroutines that modify the state rather than write pure functions.